What's going on YouTube? This is Anthony and busy day in the wood yard. It's a warm one today, hitting about 70 degrees, and it's a little bit noisy right now because we've got the garbage truck getting loaded up across the train tracks from the facility over there. And the machines are going to be fired up here, the chainsaw, the splitter. So let's get to it. First things first, I got stickers. I got Adventure Road sticker from Adventure Road's channel. I got JPF, Joe's Premium Firewood, and I even got my own. I'm gonna throw them all on my machine today. If you guys want a sticker from me, message me at OntarioFirewoodResource@gmail.com. Okay, first we'll start with my own. Sometimes these give a little trouble to peel. There we go. Put Adventure Rhoades up here, I guess, in the small area. I'm gonna try and load this splitter up. It's too bad that I don't have my B splitter in operation, and then I'd stick them on there. It would need some paint though, because it's not painted. I'd have to do that if I want to put stickers on it, but hopefully I can get that running soon. Unfortunately, it's not very busy here. It's springtime, so hopefully it picks up, but it's just the beginning of spring, so we'll see. There's Adventure Rhoades and then the JPF. Thanks for the stickers, guys. Let's go right there. He's a little bit sheltered from the rain too, you know? Maybe I should have put this one over a bit. But it's still under there. Anyways, let me show you what I gotta do today. Okay, so I got some apple under here. I might as well take this off. Got this beech. I gotta take the chainsaw out and I gotta cut it into smaller pieces. They're all about 10 to 12 inch. And I'm gonna make it all into smoker wood. I got this walnut that I gotta do, and not right now, but eventually I'm gonna get into this. This has been here for a while, so I could probably split this and put it in my crates, and a lot of this is gonna be dry for this season coming up in the fall. So that we'll touch later, but I really wanna get into this. I'm gonna bust up some of this silver maple, and I have a customer who's interested in it, so I'm gonna put it in a crate up there, some of it. I'm gonna find another crate to put some in as well. I got this load of sugar maple. I might noodle up some of these boiler pieces. I gotta make some smoker wood with the sugar maple as well, so all the cutoffs that come off of here, that's gonna be smoker wood. And then I have a crate over there where my yellow and black bag is. That's some sugar maple. I gotta make about 6 bags out of there to try and empty it out a bit before I put in a new stock. So boating season's coming up, so I gotta get this thing ready. I have my original boat cover, and then I put this tarp over it because this is a cheap Bass Pro cover and it leaks. So I'm gonna rip all this off eventually. Probably not this week, maybe the end of the week, we'll see, but it's supposed to rain. So I don't really wanna take it off yet. It is the rainy season now, but I gotta take it in to get service because it's not starting properly and it's not being very reliable. You know, once you get it going, it's okay, but it just won't start properly. And I've replaced tons of parts, and there's a whole story on that that I have on the channel in another video. I got this pile of mulberry here, and that used to be in the truck when the truck's motor died, and I split that right in the truck when I brought the splitter over there for repair. So I gotta move all this so that I can eventually get the boat out. And I got all these barrels that I gotta move around in here. And the way that I propped up my boat cover, which is always a problem, I just put a bunch of these 55 gallon drums inside, and that held up the cover really good so that all the rain and the snow could dribble off of it. So I guess might as well just start with the silver maple. Pull. logs aren't that dry, it seems, but it doesn't take long. It's lost a good bunch of moisture so far, but at the same time it's got a bit to go. But once you give it enough, and it's been sitting there for a long time, like he's been here for over a year, so that really helps the drying process start. It's not really much overall, but it's a good start. And then sometimes you put the wood away and you know, you go and you check back on it in a month or so, and then it's like super dry. So it's not gonna take months to season the wood a lot of times, you know, depending on species, of course, right? But some of these are pretty dry. Like this is silver maple, so a lot of it feels light. Like this piece is small, but it's a little more dense, so it still has a little bit of weight, but it's still light. It's starting to get warm now too. I'm gonna have to take off the sweater and it'll be my first day in the t-shirt. Even though I'm just throwing these loose in here, I'm still trying to stack them tight a little bit, you know? Save some room. Yeah, it's going up to 70 degrees today, but it doesn't feel that warm. I mean, in the sun, it's really warm. What happens if you have a couple days that are the same temperature both days coming into the summer? Then the first day will seem a little bit cooler than the second day, even though the temperatures are the same. Up too, since it's gonna rain next couple days.
Before I finish up this video, I want to send a shout out to a couple channels and I want you guys to go check them out. They've been helpful to me and I want to return the favor. First channel is Iron and Oak Sawmill with Chuck and Deb, and they do a lot of live edge slabs at their sawmill over in Pennsylvania. And then also check out Larry and Robin's channel, and that channel is Senior Firewood Homestead Larry Hottle. Larry and Robin do firewood at their place, and
all done the beech, and I got 4 bags out of it. I got one over at the shop, or is it 2? I think it's only one. I got this bag, which will be about, I don't know, maybe I'll just sell it for 10 bucks, maybe 15, or I might even just leave it aside and look for some other beech that's in my crates. I don't think there's any of the stuff that I've split fresh, probably none back there too. My only hope is in those set of crates over there, so I'll just put it aside for now. I'm not really gonna sell much of the wood that's over there. So, we'll see. I don't know. I'll make a decision on this bag. If somebody wants to buy it, maybe I'll just send it out. But I'll just keep it in the container over there for now. Take some of the stuff to the back. Try and sort it as I go along too. This is mulberry, and like I said before, it's a Some of it's dried quite a bit. And this stuff takes forever to dry.
Before I finish up this video, I want to send a shout out to a couple channels and I want you guys to go check them out. They've been helpful to me and I want to return the favor. First channel is Iron and Oak Sawmill with Chuck and Deb, and they do a lot of live edge slabs at their sawmill over in Pennsylvania. And then also check out Larry and Robin's channel, and that channel is Senior Firewood Homestead Larry Hottle. Larry and Robin do firewood at their place, and they're actually not too far away from a friend that I have down in Virginia. The Hottles are about to reach their 1,000 subscriber mark for monetization, so let's help get them those last few, get them over the edge.
Okay guys, that's it. Thanks for watching. Like, subscribe, share, comment, and all that good stuff.